Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white cat. Early in the morning, just as day is dawning, he picks up all the postbags in his van. Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white cat. All the birds are singing, and the day is just beginning. Pat feels he's a really happy man. Everybody knows his bright red van. All his friends will smile as he waves to greet them. Maybe you can never be sure there'll be knock ring letters through your door. Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white cat. All the birds are singing, the day is just beginning. Pat feels he's a really happy man. Pat feels he's a really happy man. Pat feels he's a really happy man.
Down at Greendale Village School, they had a model volcano. "Just think, children," said Mr. Pringle, "of all that rock going bubble, bubble, whoosh under the ground."
"You'd get your feet hot," said Lucy. "No, you wouldn't," said Bill Thompson. "You could wear your wellies."
"It was a long time before wellies were invented," said Mr. Pringle. "The volcanoes made our lovely Greendale Hills long before there were any people, never mind wellies. Great holes in the ground, with rock oozing out like toffee."
"Did you say toffee?" said Tom. "I like toffee."
"I said it was like toffee," said Mr. Pringle, "because it was all oozy, and it was so long ago that it was even before the dinosaurs came. You can all do a lovely painting tomorrow for open day. But it's home time now." Pat was waiting at the gate for Julian.
"Hello there."
"Hi, Dad."
"Time to go home."
"Come on, Dad, I'm hungry." "Bye, Pat." "Bye, Pat." "Bye, Pat."
"Bye."
The next morning, it seemed very quiet in the village. When Pat came to collect the letters.
"Oh, yes, I certainly will. Did you say it was near Thompson Ground? Dearie me." "Yes, yes, I'll tell him. Bye for now."
"What was all that about, Mrs. Goggins?"
"Oh, dear. Well, that was PC Selby. It seems that there's a great gaping hole in the middle of the road, near Thompson Ground. He says it's big enough to swallow a cow."
"Oh, I know what that means. Road closed, diversions, cones and bollards all over the place. How does he think I'm going to get through with all these letters and parcels?" Talking about holes in the ground, Julian was on about volcanoes and earthquakes last night.
"Nay, Pat, it's only a hole in the road."
"Oh, we'll manage somehow. Bye for now."
"Bye, Pat."
I wonder if dinosaurs would get letters.
And what did dinosaur cats look like?
I bet they ate some huge fish, eh, Jess? Alf was out on his tractor. Pat stopped for a chat. "What do you reckon to this hole in the road, Alf?"
What all? I've seen nowt. I've been ploughing since early morning.
There's a great hole just outside your farm. PC Selby shut the road off.
Oh dear,
said Alf.
How am I going to get home? I'd best be off. Bye, Pat.
Bye.
Just in case there were any new holes that no one knew about. Oh dear. Diversion. So we can't go our usual way. I know PC Selby and his diversions. Every time it ends up me going the long way round. Hey up. What's this? Oh no, not another. And it's going back the other way. What? More diversions? They're everywhere. Here we go again. Oh, this is awful. I'm getting dizzy going right and then left, then right again. I should go straight on. Maybe if I went left. But I can't. I could go right here. I've just spotted where we are, Jess.
We're back where we started.
Then Alf came chugging along.
Don't follow me, said Pat. I'm lost. If you follow these signs, you just go round in a big circle.
Nay, Pat, I can't be bothered with all that, said Alf. I have to get home and get my dinner. Let's shift this clutter out of the way. No problem.
Pat followed.
Is this what all the fuss is about?
Said Alf.
It doesn't look much to me.
I've seen bigger, said Pat.
A baby one.
Now then, what's going on there?
Look out, here comes trouble. PC Selby.
Come on, lads. You know this road's closed. You must have seen the signs. I'll have to take your names and addresses. Here, can you hold my tea?
Don't be daft, Arthur. You've known us ever since we were in short trousers.
Never mind that. We have to do it proper. Now then, how do you spell proceeding? You haven't got a pencil sharpener on you by any chance?
Here we are, a nice fresh cup of tea.
Oh, thanks, Dorothy, said Pat. Just what we need.
Dorothy, have you got anything to sharpen Arthur's pencil? Hang on, Pat, if you could just hold this. And then, Arthur, pass your pencil to Dorothy. Then if you take these...
But I've nothing to sharpen pencils with.
I think there are two E's in proceeding. But is it a C or an S?
I thought you said...
Just bring the tea.
Has anyone seen my notebook?
Let's go home, Dot.
I think it's going round in circles like my van.
Talking about that, you've given me an idea. Now,
If we made everything go through Elf's yard instead, we could probably...
Dandelions everywhere. I wonder if there are any holes here.
When Pat called on Miss Hubbard, she was acting very oddly, prodding about the garden with a stick.
It's very dangerous having holes in one's garden.
Oh, morning, Pat.
Morning, Miss Hubbard. You've not lost something, have you?
Certainly not. I'm just taking precautions. Holes, you know, appearing without warning. P.C. Selby told me all about it.
Oh, I wouldn't let it bother you, Miss Hubbard. It's only a small hole in the road. Cheerio.
Bye, Pat.
Bye.
Pat called on Ted Glenn.
Hello, Pat.
Hello there.
There was a parcel for him. Sorry I'm a bit late today, said Pat. It's this blooming hole in the road. I've had to go all round Greendale to get here.
Don't worry. Leave it to me. I'll have that hole filled in no time. A bag of cement, a bit of gravel and some tar. That'll sort it out. All leftovers from a job in Pencaster. I knew it'd come in handy one day.
Champion, said Pat.
Ta-da, Pat. Cheerio.
Pat was on his way. Having delivered all his letters, it was time to go back to the post office. But he stopped at Thompson Ground to see how things were going. There was a whole new set of signs, leading into a field and through Alf's yard, where Ted's lorry was parked.
It's like town centre here,
said Alf.
My poor hens. That's if you can find them, poor things. They'll not lay for a fortnight. Here comes another. Oh, it's Sam. Good morning. See what I mean, Pat? It's terrible.
He'll be all right, said Pat, as soon as Ted gets that hole filled in.
Come on, slowly as you go. Careful now.
Tail, called Dorothy from the kitchen door.
And fresh biscuits straight from the oven.
Just what I need, said Ted. We'll have a sup while that tar sets. Are you coming for your tea, Arthur? Mind the tar, will you?
Help! Help! Here, don't... Come back! Help!
But something seemed to be keeping P.C. Selby.
Help! Come back! Help!
Did somebody shout help? Said Pat.
He's not looking for his notebook, is he?
Said Alf.
He hasn't gone and trod in it, has he?
What are you doing to my nice new tar? Fast-setting stuff, that. A new kind, you know.
You'll have to take your boots off and leave them in charge, said Pat.
Come on, Arthur. Off with your boots. Don't be shy. One, two, and lift. Oops.
Here, hold on.
Time for a bit of farm transport, said Alf.
Oh! Hey, steady on. My boots. How am I going to walk?
And we'll need a new warning sign.
Stay still and I'll tip you over.
Very undignified, this. I'll never live it down.
There. Danger. Police boots. Everybody should see that. I hope Dorothy's kept some tea hot. Postman Pat is collecting the post at Garner Bridge Post Office. What's this? A new poster? Garner Hall open to the public? Well, bless me. Mind you, it'll be a lovely show. It's a fine house.
Oh, but Pat, said Mrs. Goggins, just think of all the cars and coaches and the litter. Oh, and Miss Hubbard did ask particular for you to drop in and have a word. I don't know what she wants.
I expect it's something to do with this opening of Garner Hall. I'll not forget. Cheerio.
Bye, Pat. Cheerio.
All right, Jess. I'm coming. You never know. Miss Hubbard might have some cream for you today. But I hope she doesn't want a hand with her blooming bees. I remember last time. Pat was still wondering what Miss Hubbard could want. No bees about anyway.
Come in, Pat.
Where are you, Miss Hubbard?
In here, Pat. Just come through.
There were piles of paper everywhere.
Oh, now where has the fellow got to?
Goodness me, Miss Hubbard. Hey up, there's a draft. Whoops! Oh, I've made a right mess.
Oh, for heaven's sake, man, shut that door.
Don't worry, I'll pick these up. Whoops! Sorry.
Oh, but don't make the place untidy, Pat. Just put that pile where you can.
I wouldn't like to sort this lot out.
I'm just getting ready for the grand opening of Garner Hall. The Major has asked me to show people round, and I must find out all about the old times in Greendale.
Oh, yes, I saw the poster. Well, I don't know if much has happened in Greendale. No famous battles, no ghosts, nothing like that.
Ah, don't be so sure, Pat. You never know what you'll find in some of these old papers. Tell you what, Pat, there's one thing I would like to see. Folks say Granny Dryden has a very old diary that her granddad kept, and he was head butler at Garner Hall 100 years ago. Now, if you were to ask her, she might just lend it.
It's worth a try. I'll ask her when I call with the letters.
I feel sure she'll let you have it. Do please ask her. I'll take good care of it.
I'll pop in when I finish my letters and let you know how I get on. Oops, I nearly forgot your post. Cheerio.
Good man. Bye for now.
Pat was on his way. His next stop was at Ted Glenn's.
Hello, Ted. What's he doing? Making a right clatter. Ted!
Hello, Pat. You gave me quite a fright. I didn't hear you come in. Look at this. Just like new. All ready for the grand opening.
I know. Of Garner Hall.
A knight in shining armour. What do you reckon, Pat? I've always fancied trying this stuff on.
Well, now's your chance. I'll bring a tin opener next time I call, just in case you get stuck. Here's some mail to go with it. Cheerio!
Ta-da, Pat!
Pat was on his way. His next stop was at Granny Dryden's.
Now then, what was it that Miss Hubbard wanted?
Hello, anybody at home?
Oh, Pat, I'm glad to see you. I've just been sorting out some old stuff. There's this diary. Come and have a look. It takes me back seeing these old pages. Wilfred's very words, just as he wrote them all that long time ago.
I never saw anything like it. Do you think I could borrow it so that Miss Hubbard could make a few notes for when she shows folk around?
Well, I can't make it out properly with me glasses, so you might as well take it.
I'll take great care of it. I promise.
Bye, Pat.
Bye, Granny Dryden. Cheerio.
It was time for Pat to be getting along to Garner Hall. Miss Hubbard would be waiting for him and the precious diary. Garner Hall at last. Major Forbes was at the door looking out for Pat.
Come along, Pat. I see that you've got the diary. Miss Hubbard's waiting for you.
Pat, good man, and the diary. Now, let me see. There must be something here.
Where do I put this lot? Over there, Ted. Near the chimney. Oops, makes a right clatter, this stuff does.
Oh, how can I write the history of Garner Hall with this racket going on?
Come and sit in the library, Miss Hubbard. You'll find it nice and peaceful in there.
Oh, thank you, Major. So kind.
Ted seemed to think the suit of armour was a new kind of jigsaw puzzle.
Just about my size, I reckon. Let's see.
I'd better leave you to it, Ted.
Bye.
Is that you, Pat?
I was on my way out. Just about to leave, Miss Hubbard.
I want to show you something.
Something wrong?
Pat, what am I going to do? Look at these diaries.
Well, what's wrong with them, Miss Hubbard?
Wrong? Wrong, Pat? There's not a thing in them that I can put in my story of Garner Hall. They're just... just boring, Pat. Look.
It was a nice day today. Went fishing, caught 3 trout, went to bed early. Well, yes, I see what you mean. Nothing very historical about that.
Historical? Oh, Pat, it makes me feel hysterical. Look, I haven't got a single note on my paper, not a thing.
Meanwhile, Ted seemed to be having trouble with the armour.
Help, Pat! Get me out of here, I'm stuck! Get your tin opener, I can't see where... God. You can't leave me like this. Oh, boy. Are you there, Pat? This armour's a bit stiff. Boy.
Come and see. There's some monster going straight through the flower beds in a suit of armour. Look.
Let's have a look. You're right. A suit of armour. And I think I know who's in it.
Bayek. Oh, me back. Where am I? You can't leave me like this. Get me the fire brigade. What's this in front of you? Ow! Oh, bloody hell. Did you say, Pat, did you say my suit of armor, eh, what? Out here, in the flower beds? Parading about?
Yes, Major. It was...
It should be in the hall.
I know, Major, but look at your flowers.
all crushed and spoilt.
Badgers, foxes, deer, no stopping the blighters. That's what it is. Sounds more like an elephant, Major. A whole herd of them, if you ask me, Pat.
Miss Hubbard was waving like mad from the window. I think it's gone back inside. Come along, Major. Which way?
This way! Follow me! Charge! Where is he? Dashed if the fellow's disappeared again.
I'm sure I heard something in here.
But the suit of armor! It's gone!
What was that? Sounds as though you've got mice. Big metal ones.
It came from behind that door.
If only I could see where I'm going.
Hey, look at this. A door. And a secret passage. Hello, suit of armor.
Hello, everybody. Glad to get this helmet off. Got stuck. Couldn't see a thing.
It's so dark in here. But what's this?
I've found an old book in your secret cupboard, Major.
Good fellow. Might be something Miss Hubbard could use.
Something for me? Ooh. What have you found?
Old papers. What luck.
Just what we need.
Yes. Good gracious. Incredible. Just the stuff. And at the last minute, too. Very lucky. You never know what skeletons there might be in an old cupboard.
Time for tea, eh, what?
It was a warm morning in Greendale. And there were plenty of letters and parcels for Pat to deliver. That's the village just about done. Major Forbes was busy reading his paper. Morning, Major.
Morning, Pat. I say, this print gets smaller and smaller. Can't see the half of it.
Well now, Major, I couldn't read a thing without my glasses. It might mean that you need a pair. It's ever so fuzzy and blurred without them.
Oh, what a nuisance. I suppose I'll have to pop into Pencaster for an eye test. My Aunt Penny sat on her glasses once. Smashed them to bits. Very painful, what?
Cheerio, Major. What would I do without my glasses?
And another for Miss Hubbard. Oh, there you are, Pat. That's all the country letters sorted now. All ready for you.
It's warming up now outside. Phew, that's better. Oh, nice. Hello, who's that?
Ooh, Bayek. Ooh. Catch hold of that corner, Pat. It's a bit... Oops. It's a right weight.
Ooh, be careful.
Just get it on there. That's it. Push.
I hope it's nothing that breaks easily. It went down with a bit of a thump.
Nay, it's all right, Pat. I'm glad to get it here all in one piece.
Oh, Ted, what a monster. I can't be doing with this on my counter all morning.
I rang Pencaster Parcel Office and they said they'd pick it up just as soon as possible.
Just look at that time. I'd better be off. Where did I put my hat? And where am I...
Look under there, Pat.
Here we go.
Don't drop it. I can feel something. Oh. Oh. Dear me.
Oh, Pat, are those your glasses?
What's left of them? They're not much use now. How am I going to deliver these letters? I can't see to drive, never mind read the addresses.
Now, Pat, Ted can take you home in his lorry and you can get your spare pair of glasses.
What spare pair?
Oh, Pat, haven't you got a spare pair?
No, I've never broken them before. I've had these for years and years.
Well, you'll have to borrow some, Pat.
You can try my old ones. They might do.
Don't worry, Pat. We can take the letters round in the lorry. I can give you a hand.
Well, I certainly won't be able to drive.
Here we are. Now, give these a try, Pat.
Oh, Tar. Well, it's better than nothing. Just a bit fuzzy.
Oh, we'll manage somehow.
Here we are.
Thanks, Mrs. Goggins. Bye for now.
Oh, dear. Careful, Pat. Goodness me. Oh.
Don't worry. I'll keep an eye on him.
Oh, dear. I'm sorry, Mrs. Goggins.
You can see that he needs looking after.
Cheerio.
Bye, Pat.
Oops.
Dr. Gilbertson was out doing her shopping.
Ah, who's this? Hello. Getting hot, isn't it? Now then, Dorothy. I've got lots of letters for you. This looks like one of yours. Here we are. Have a good read.
Pat, that's not Dorothy.
Oh, ooh.
Are you feeling ill, Pat?
I'm sorry, Doctor. It's my glasses, squashed flat under a parcel.
They don't look squashed to me.
These are your letters, Doctor.
What on earth is going on?
Better be on our way with the letters.
The next stop was at the church.
I think this lot has got all muddled. Tell you what, Pat, we can let the tailgate down. And we'll have a good place to sort them out.
I'll just deliver this lot whilst you sort the rest.
Are you sure you've got all the Reverend's letters?
I'd know them with my eyes shut.
Oops,
what's this?
Good Lord, deliver us. You are Pat, aren't you? Sorry, Pat, I've got the wrong glasses on.
I know just how you feel, Reverend. I've got Mrs. Goggins' old glasses on.
Did you say?
Yes, but it's a long story. Have some letters. Better be on my way, Reverend. Cheerio.
But, Pat, This is for the Reverend, Pat. I think you've got him muddled again. Pat, these are not for me at all. They're a bit fuzzy, but I do believe it says Miss Hubbard on this one. You'll have to excuse him, Reverend. You see, his glasses were squashed flat. They look all right to me.
It's a long story. And I think it'll be best if you read out all the addresses for me from now on, Ted.
No problem. I wish I could help. But you see, my proper glasses... lost them somewhere.
It's nice of you to offer to help. Thanks, Reverend. And cheerio.
I wonder where I've put them. Bye, Pat.
Off they went.
Here we are, Thompson Ground. There's Alf's catalogue. Now you can't go wrong with that.
Alf can't be far away. Anybody in? Ooh. I wish Alf, ouch, wouldn't leave these for me to fall in. This looks more like it. A nice big letterbox, just the job. Catalogue away.
Did you find Alf then?
He wasn't about. I just popped it in their new letterbox.
New letterbox? They haven't got a new letterbox.
See for yourself.
Show me.
Here we are. Didn't I tell you? A new letterbox.
An old barn door with a missing plank, more like. Locked up as well. Now then, how are we going to get it back? Hang on, I'll get someone to help us.
Let's have a look around. If only I could see properly.
Ouch!
Where does this go? I could get in through the window. Anybody there? Anybody in? Ooh! Ouch! What happened?
Pat, where are you?
Ted! Ooh, it's dark in here. Where's Ted?
You all right, Pat? Hello, Ted! Having a nice talk to my barn door? Hello, Alf. Nay. I'm talking to Pat. He's inside.
Well, how's he got in there? It's all locked up. I don't know if I've got the key.
Ted!
Let's see.
You look a right mess, Pat.
Here's your catalogue, Alf.
Delivered safe and sound.
Oh, Ted and Pat, back at last. I've been ringing round everywhere trying to track you down.
There's nothing else gone wrong, has there?
Oh, no, Pat. It's just that... after you'd gone, I found these. They look awfully like yours. They must have slipped down behind the stamp book. That huge parcel must have given them a push.
Magic! I can see again. Oh, that's lovely. They must be mine. Thank you, Mrs. Goggins.
Hang on. We saw them all smashed up.
No, we didn't.
There must have been another pair of glasses on the counter.
Whose could they be?
Well, the Reverend came in before you this morning, and he must have left his glasses here. He didn't mind about his glasses being broken. Said he needed a new pair anyway.
Well, I never. I wonder if I need glasses.
The post would never have got through without you. Thanks, Ted.
Back to the workshop. Cheerio.
Cheerio.
Bye, Ted.
There was a touch of spring in the air in Greendale. Pat was on his way. A lovely scent of blossom wafted in at his open window. There wasn't much post today, so he had time to stop.
Ooh, isn't it grand?
Come on, Jess. Stretch your paws.
Well, look who's here.
Morning, Miss Hubbard.
Oh, morning, Pat.
Just the day for a bit of painting.
Pat, my canvas, quick, catch it!
I'll get it. Well caught, Hedge. Quite a lively picture this'll be. Here we are, Miss Hubbard, all safe.
Oh, thank you, Pat. This is a most important canvas for the Garner Bridge Art Show. The Pencaster Gazette's offering a prize, a very big prize, I believe. Just think of that.
Well, I never saw that. I've been too busy sorting out letters to read the paper.
Ah, here we go. Not a bad start.
Well, is it? I mean, all that yellow. It fair makes you squint.
Now then, Pat, what do you think of that?
I think the wind's trying to paint you.
Oh, no good, Pat. I'll have to go home and paint a pot of flowers on the kitchen table.
Next day, Pat was out in his van again. There was a parcel for Ted.
Morning, Ted.
Morning, Pat. I hope you've got a parcel for me.
I have, and it looks like something special.
Special? I should think so. It's a thingamy what's it for this doolally gadget I'm making for the Pencaster Art Show.
Well, I wouldn't mind having a go, but I don't think I could make a doolally what's it.
Well, there's all sorts of things you could try. What about a spot of painting? I've plenty of tins with a bit left in. I'd be glad to get them used up.
I was watching Miss Hubbard yesterday. It looks a bit messy, especially when the wind gets up.
What you want is a nice lump of clay.
That sounds more my style. But where could I get such a thing as a lump of clay?
I've got a tin of some special stuff. They sent it for me to try out. It's like clay. I haven't got time to bother with it. You're welcome to try if you like.
I'll have a go.
Here you are, plenty there. Just read the instructions.
Thanks, Ted.
But what's this thing you're making? What does it do?
Now then, don't tell anybody, Pat. It's to be a secret until the show opens. They've never seen anything like this. It all works with the wind, you see. That's what this fan's here for. What? I'd better be off.
I've had enough wind today to last me for a long time.
Cheerio.
Bye, Pat.
What about a clay mouse, Jess? That might do.
At Greendale Post Office...
What's this business about?
Everybody was talking.
Hello there. Morning, Pat.
Morning, Pat.
Morning, Major.
About the art show.
How wonderful to have an art show in our community. Last time I did any painting, what? Painted the fence all round the barracks. Made a bit of a mess of it.
When I was a girl, I was a wonder at needlework. Embroidery, all that sort of thing. I can't hold a brush properly now. It's these rheumatics, you know.
Oh, yes, I'm sure. I just have to sort out these letters.
It was 60 Julian has years some nice ago, stuff. Committal.
When I was on fatigue,
I remember.
What's this do with
this little thing? I'm losing my numbers.
Quiet, everybody! Now, look, folks, I have these letters to sort out. And if you want any advice, you'd best go have a word with Mr. Pringle down at the school.
Follow me.
I wonder if he would accept the small model I have. Painting by
these
numbers.
Were cushions. Cross stitching. A bit faded by now.
Hello, Mrs. Goggins. Do you know?
If it's about that blessed poster and the art show, no, Pat, I don't. The whole of Greendale's all a buzz about it, and I'm tired of answering silly questions. Besides, there's a deal of post coming, so there'll be no time for chatting.
Thanks, Mrs. Goggins.
Bye, Pat.
I'm thinking of having a go at something. Just wait and see.
It was a quiet evening for Pat. Sarah was at the WI. Julian was doing his homework. Pat had a look at the Pencaster Gazette. Then he remembered.
Now then, what shall I make? First job, get it out of the tin. What does it say? I wish Ted hadn't spilt paint on it. Keep warm and mix a small amount of water. I can't see the rest. Never mind.
Hey up! Oh dear. Oof! It's alive! Help! More like glue than clay. Oops! Oh! My goodness! Ooh, I'd better get a move on. Oh dear. Get off!
The next morning, Pat phoned Ted.
Hello, Ted.
Hey, old butt. How are you doing?
I had a spot of bother with that clay stuff you gave me.
Took me till bedtime to clean it up.
What did you make? A mess, that's what I made, Ted. Nothing else. You should have heard what Sarah said when she came home.
You'll have to follow the instructions, Pat. I'll see if I can get a leaflet about it. I know I've got one somewhere.
Pat just had to have another try. It's beginning to look like... something familiar.
Ah,
Jess was getting fidgety. At last, the day of the art show came. On the way to George Lancaster's, Pat's van was making some very peculiar noises. George heard the noise and came to have a look.
Morning, George. What's wrong, Pat?
Ooh, I don't know. She just conked out.
Let's have a look. I know a thing or two about motors.
Sam Waldron arrived.
Hi, Sam. Hello, Pat. Anything wrong? The main manifold to the exhaust. I suppose it'll do. This distributor looks icky. Hey, Pat. These plugs are mucky.
Oh?
Let's have a shifty. There's nothing wrong with the van, Pat. It's just that it won't run on fresh air. You're out of petrol.
Oh, what a noodle I am. And I'll miss the art show. They're picking the winner this afternoon.
Here you are. I can spare you a drop. Enough to get you down to the village anyway.
Thanks, Sam. Bye.
Cheerio, bye.
The van went much better with petrol in it. But not for long. Oh, dear.
No.
Oh, come on, Jess. We'll have to walk the rest of the way. Pat was out of puff when he got to the school. There was no sign of the judge.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, Pat.
Am I too late?
Ah, hello, Pat.
Ah, there's Sarah.
Hello there.
Pat, over here.
She was looking after Pat's model of Jess. Someone had stuck a notice on it.
Hello, Sarah.
What's this? Special award? Greendale prize?
It's a special prize, Pat. Something about your model saving the show.
I didn't think my model was... Hang on. There's something missing. His tail. His tail's missing. I gave him a nice bushy tail.
But...
Hello, Ted.
Could you spare a minute?
Is there a flood?
There was a leak. You see that pipe? That's a nice lump of clay wrapped round the pipe. That's Jesse's tail. The cold water makes the clay go hard, so it's just the thing to stop a leak. Without that, we would have had to close the show down.
I think Jess deserves first prize. After all, he did help to stop a flood.
He's a first prize cat, is our Jess. Pat was out and about as usual, with the village letters. Morning, Peter.
Morning, Pat.
Morning, Pat.
Morning, Dr. Gilbertson. Nothing for you today.
Good morning, Mrs. Goggins. you look busy.
Hello, Pat. Give me a minute, will you, until I've sorted this out. Oh, drat this string.
Now then, Mrs. Goggins, you just want to take it slowly. Once you find the end...
That's easier said than done.
Well, it must have an end.
Now he tells me.
Dear me, it does seem to be in a mess. Well, I better be on my way with these letters. Good luck.
Bye.
Bye.
I wonder if I could cut it into small pieces.
Right, Jess. Ready for off?
Jess had been waiting a long time. Never mind, Jess. There might be some mice in Alf's barn. Then you can have a good run. Pat and Jess were on their way along the winding lanes.
What's that? Hold on tight, Jess. A piece of string across the road? Whatever can it be doing here? I hope it's not part of Mrs. Goggins' tangle. We'd better wind it up before anybody else gets caught up in it. Well, I never. It goes right over this wall.
Jess came to have a look. I should have known you'd want to play.
I think we'd better see where it goes to. It goes right across the field. It must be a very long piece of string.
Oh, dear.
Come on, Jess. It looks like being a long walk. There was a scarecrow in the middle of the field holding the string for Pat. Hello, Mr. Scarecrow.
Let's see. It's a bit tight there. Oh, dear.
There we are.
That's much better.
Sorry to leave you like this, Mr. Scarecrow, but I must go.
My goodness. But this field is muddy.
Pat came to a wall. Jess was waiting for him.
How much further does this string go?
Over the wall. Hup.
Hello, Jess. Where have you been?
Oh!
Ouch!
Yow! Ooh, prickles.
Oh, lots of them.
Ow.
I've lost Jess again.
Oh, dear.
No, I haven't. Now, Jess, don't go disappearing again. Ooh, I'll just get my puff back.
That's better. Ooh, isn't it grand?
How much further does this string go? And what have we here? Sheep. A field full of sheep.
They were standing on his string. He started to pull.
Can you all stand still for a minute whilst I sort this out?
Bye-bye, sheep.
Pat was thinking that it must be a very long piece of string to have come this far when he came to a gap in a wall. The string went through the gap and up another hill to a tall tree, where it finally disappeared into the leaves and branches.
Well, there must be something special at the end of such a very long piece of string. Whatever can it be? Who is that behind the tree? Oh, goodness me. Young Katie and Tom. What are you doing here? And what are you looking such miseries about?
It's our new super kite, Pat. Stuck in the top of this tree. We can't get it down.
Pat pulled at the string, but the kite would not move. It looks well and truly stuck. There's Peter. I wonder if he can help.
Peter! Peter!
What but with the noise of the tractor, Peter Fogg didn't hear Pat's call.
Peter! Peter!
Hello, Pat!
I was just asking myself how to get the twins' kite down from that big tree. I wonder if your tractor would be high enough for me to stand on, and...
I'd like to help, Pat, but I don't think this tractor's big enough. Sorry, got to finish before it gets dark. Bye, Pat.
Bye.
Then Ted Glenn's lorry came round the corner. It had a ladder on the back.
Ted! Ted! Stop a minute!
Hello, Ted. Can we borrow your ladder for 5 minutes to get a kite out of that tree?
Well, I can't be too late. I've got to mend Dr. Gilbertson's greenhouse before the frost gets at her tomatoes.
It won't take long.
Is that young Katie and Tom? Is it their kite?
Yes, 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 it is.
Right. Let's see what we can do. You go that end, Pat. Are you ready?
I've got it. Pat and Ted soon had that ladder off the lorry.
Round she goes.
And over the wall.
Hang on, Ted.
I'll nip into the field.
Right you are. Whoops-a-daisy. Climbing walls. Reminds me when I was young. Off we go.
I could never have done this by myself, Ted.
Not with a ladder like this, you couldn't.
Up she goes.
Mind your fingers.
I'll hold the ladder, Pat, and you go and have a look. Mind yourself.
I'll soon deal with this, never fear.
Steady as you go.
It was going to be a long climb, seeing it was a tall tree. Well, bless me. There's the kite. And Jess as well. How did you get here, Jess? Come on, Jess. Don't be frightened. Come on. Look out! Oh, there goes the kite.
Quick, catch it!
Hooray!
Oh, thanks, Pat.
Clever Pat.
And clever Jess, too.
We've got the kite. But poor old Jess is stuck up here now.
Well, I'll have to get a move on. Dr. Gilbertson will never forgive me if the frost gets to her tomatoes.
Jess got up the tree on his own, so I hope he can get down the way he went up.
You don't need to bother about Jess. He's already here, waiting for you.
Bless us all. Has that cat got wings? Now, off you go home, Katie and Tom, before it gets dark. And keep a good hold on that kite.
Bye, Pat.
Bye-bye, Pat.
Hang on. I'll give you a hand with that ladder.
Are you ready, Pat?
Ready when you are, Ted. Back to the lorry.
Give it a push, Pat.
Over to you, Ted.
Okay, now leave it to me.
Thanks, Ted. Good luck with the greenhouse.
Bye, Pat.
Hello, have you popped up again? You get everywhere, don't you, Jess? Ted was on his way. Pat waved to him, then went to look for his van. He still had his letters to deliver. The only thing was, well, all the fields looked alike, and Pat didn't know which way to go. And Jess had disappeared again. Now, that looks like somebody I know.
it was Mr. Pringle.
Hello, Pat. Just out for a walk, you know. Looking for your van, maybe? Well, yes, I was just wondering. Three fields that way. Turn left at the boggy bit. And you'll be there in a jiffy.
It seemed much further than Mr. Pringle had said. He came to a road. It looked like one that Pat knew.
Ah, there's my van. Safe and sound.
Where's Jess? I can't leave without him.
I should have guessed. Fast asleep in his basket.
We'd better get these letters delivered.
Don't want to be late for tea, do we, Jess?